the first question is, what is the minimum daily dose of sulforaphane that has shown to that has been shown to provide health benefits? How much sulforaphane does a 200 gram serving of broccoli or broccoli sprouts contain?
Yeah, so you know, I have to preface launching into the answers to some of these questions by saying, yeah, you went through the extensive and wonderful questions, many of them, as did I a number of days ago. This is a kind of question that comes up all the time. And to those of you who are non-scientists, I tend to talk we scientists, and certainly chemists and biochemists, tend to talk in micromoles. So if you look at any of our papers, we talk micromoles. I will try to give you an answer that's translated into milligrams, but this is, of course, complex and something that's still in play and is still being researched by many people. So it all depends on the amount of glucoraphanin, the precursor of sulforaphane, that is in broccoli or sprouts. I'm going to avoid a long diatribe on glucoraphanin and myrosinase and sulforaphane, because I have the feeling that if you've listened to Rhonda at all or gone to our podcast, the podcast that she and I did together, or some of her subsequent podcasts, most people know about the fact that glucoraphanin is a precursor found in the plants. Myrosinase is an enzyme found in the plants and in your body, your microbiome. And they react and they form sulforaphane. So
I think that's so interesting, but that we have the enzyme in our gut, meaning we are meant to get the precursor to convert it into sulforaphane. We contain the enzyme in our gut. I just love that. Yep. Anyways, go ahead.
So absolutely, all of us do. And I mean that, all, however many hundred of you there are in this call, all have myrosinase containing bacteria in your gut, unless you've just blasted yourself with antibiotics and had a, you know, an enema and just cleaned out your intestinal system, then maybe you don't have any. And we've done these sorts of experiments actually with real people. So there are two ways of doing this, of hydrolyzing the glucoraphanin that's present in broccoli. One is when you chew it, you release the enzyme from the broccoli tissue or broccoli sprouts or broccoli seeds. And the second way is from your microbiome. And if you take supplements, you're either getting just glucoraphanin, or there are now supplements with a combination of glucoraphanin and myrosinase. And there are very few, if any, good ones with just sulforaphane. And we'll get to that later, I'm sure. We have to. So the question was about the dose. And if you're the best advice that we can give, that I can give now, is that all the clinical studies seem to be pointing towards a dose of something between about 50 and 100 micromoles of sulforaphane a day. I discussed that a little bit in the sprouting PDF that Rhonda has just put out. But the question that was originally posted talks about a 200 gram. So let's start with the question, a 200 gram serving of broccoli. That's a pretty lot for most people, I think. That's a very healthy serving of broccoli, market stage broccoli. However, broccoli sprouts, that's a huge serving. Most people that I'm aware of, including myself, would not enjoy cramming down 200 grams of broccoli sprouts. So I'll just base a ballpark estimation on 100 grams of either broccoli or sprouts. And based on the amount of glucoraphanin that's in them and our knowledge of conversion and yield, you might get about anywhere between 4 milligrams of glucoraphanin to 100-150 from 100 grams of broccoli. And that would yield about anywhere from about half a milligram to something like 18 milligrams of sulforaphane. That's a broccoli. Why is there a huge range? There's a huge range because A, all of the broccoli is different. It's different based on the way it's treated in the store, the way it's grown, the genetics of the broccoli. And secondly, all of you are different, and your gut microbiomes are going to yield different amounts of sulforaphane. So there's a huge range. And with broccoli sprouts, 100 grams would give you somewhere between, I don't know, about 5 milligrams and 350, between about 5 or 6 milligrams and about 60 milligrams of sulforaphane. So these are just rough approximations. Cooking destroys myrosinase. So if you're cooking broccoli or broccoli sprouts, then you're just counting on the bacteria in your gut. I mentioned the person-to-person variation. There's no way, unfortunately, to know if you're a good converter. There's no way to know how much sulforaphane or glucoraphanin is in broccoli or broccoli sprouts, because you have to get them tested in a lab. And there are no commercial labs that do these tests routinely. So this is still a problem. I mentioned this in that PDF that Rhonda's posted, but unfortunately, you as a consumer are, you know, even if you spend, say, $10 on broccoli seeds and sprout them yourself, it would cost you $150 to send one sample of those broccoli seeds out to a commercial lab to get them tested to see if they're high glucoraphanin or not. So I don't make the rules, I just abide by them or try to. But so unfortunately, as it stands now, it's very difficult to know what you're getting. So we just have to work, we just have to talk in terms of rough averages. And when Paul Talley and I did our first publication on broccoli sprouts, you know, our point was that a serving of, say, something like a couple of ounces, 60 grams or so of broccoli sprouts, gave you as much glucoraphanin as, a quarter of a pound or a half a pound of market stage broccoli. And so these are all quantities. One final word, and just that the quantity of glucoraphanin and sulforaphane you get from broccoli sprouts, from a couple of ounces, we think is a reasonable amount to put you in a zone where you're getting some protective effect. And so it's roughly this level that most of the clinical studies have targeted, because God forbid your clinical study should be positive and work. You want to be able to translate that to something people can eat. I think the answers to all the rest of my questions will be shorter, Rhonda, and you've been gracious not to jump in and interrupt, but I hope that's sort of addressed the question.